Sam was talking about the other day when y'all trained the Mercedes-Benz the first time. It kind of got so loud y'all couldn't hear Martino very well, even though you're standing like 10 yards away from him. I'm curious how that's going to work during a game when there's going to be 40,000 and then 70,000 people.
Well, it's going to be loud. It's going to be very loud. It's difficult. It's hard, but I think that, you know, the game kind of tells you what to do. I think that there will be times, though, on restarts and things like that, where we've got to organize that it's going to be tough. But everyone's got to be tuned in. You know, you can't really lose your head and not think about what you need to be doing because, you know, people aren't going to be able to tell you very easily.
And your experience, how has that been dealt with? Is it hand signals? Is it on brakes, getting direction, and one guy telling the other guy, and down a chain it goes, like a telephone game kind
of
thing?
Yeah, when there are moments to kind of regroup, whether the ball's, you know, out of bounds for a corner kick and they're setting up, those are really the only moments you get. But even in those times, you've got to be focused on what you're doing. So there'll be times where you're screaming as loud as you can and nothing's happening. So it's something we'll have to get used to. But, you know, Bobby Dodd was very loud as well. You know, we figured that out.
And where is that most dangerous, the inability to communicate? Set pieces or defending set pieces or what is it?
Well, obviously, on set pieces, you need to be communicating, but there are things in practice. You know, there's roles and jobs that you need to do, so you can kind of take care of that. I think when the ball turns over, you're in a counterattack, or someone went forward and now their man is behind them, those quick moments are the difficult ones, and I think that's something that Dallas does really well.
Okay.
So we'll have to be alert.
And you've trained on the turf, wherever it is, here a couple of times. What is the biggest adjustment that y'all are going to need to make playing on that now with 9 of your next 10 games on turf compared to the grass at Bobby Dodd?
Well, I think that we'll train as much as we can on turf without overdoing it. So I think, you know, before each game, we'll probably get some time on it. You know, a lot of the guys in the lineup aren't used to turf, so they'll have to really get used to it. But it's a different surface, you know. It's a different thing altogether. When it's dry, it's hard. When it's wet, it's fast. So you have to get used to the little nuances of it. But I think with all these games, it should happen pretty quickly for us.
And y'all prefer it wet and fast.
Yeah, right. Yeah, definitely. I mean, when it's dry, it just checks out those funny things. When it's wet, it's good. You know, you can move the ball quickly, and I think that would be good for us.
And how does the bounces compare, for example?
Well, if it's wet, it'll just skip. It'll be really, really fast.
Okay.
If it's dry, it'll do the opposite. It'll check up. You know, there's a lot of friction, so the wet is going to get sort of wet.
And somebody on Twitter was asking last night about the little black pellet things that come out of the field. Does that affect anything?
No. I mean, that's artificial cushioning.
Is that what that's called? Okay.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. It gives it, you know, a little bit of softness.
Okay.
Jeff, talk about the break and just kind of what that's done for you guys. Has it been a, you know, resurgence, kind of just recharge your batteries? Tell me about what you guys, I know you've been practicing.
Yeah, it just seems like this is like the second or third time we've had this year. I think we're getting used to it in that we know how big this month is, how many games there are, and just trying to let yourself rest mentally is kind of the most important thing. We've been training hard, but I think that, you know, guys enjoy a couple of days off, regroup before you have a long, 3-4 weeks ahead of us.
You guys enjoy that? You guys are kind of right there. I mean, the playoffs are just ahead of you. You're there. These games mean something, these down the stretch games.
These are huge. I mean, we've put ourselves in a position to, we're sitting on top of the red line, which is good. But it really all comes down to this. For the next, hopefully, 3 months, we'll really just be pushing. But then again, you know, October comes, we have another weekend off. So this is really what it's all about. A lot of Eastern Conference rivals coming into our building, so that's what we're going to have to take care of.
How important now, Kenwin's back, Jacob is back and playing a little bit, just to have a mostly full squad, with the exception of Carlton and Gosling, who are going to be off with the 17 to 21.
Yeah, I think even if we didn't have a cluster of games in this month, it would be great to have everyone healthy. That's obviously what you want, full roster. But now with all of these games, it's a necessity. Everyone's going to get a chance. Everyone's going to have to play a part. I think that over the summer we had done that. You know, Jake scoring goals and Brandon coming in and players kind of filling in, which has been good, but it's everyone's going to have to raise a level because everyone's going to get a chance and the games are a lot bigger.
And other than counterattacking, what does Dallas do well?
That they've got pace. Pace on the wings, true goal scorer up front. They tend to go on the road and sit deep, defend deep. Teams have done that to us a bunch lately. It's just when the ball turns over, they get some of those wingers running at you. It can be really hard. That's what they tend to play for on the road, and something we're going to have to prepare for.
Anything else, Jeff?